PopKern's exclusive sponsor is Bakersfield Heart Hospital.
Happy Friday and welcome back to PopKern. I'm your host, Nicole Gitzke. Now, we are in the midst of a pandemic, and that has changed just about everything we know, including how we shop. But that doesn't mean the deals are off this Black Friday, which is just only a week away. Now, we are here in town checking out how to score those best deals and steals, whether you're planning on shopping inside of a store or going online. Let's check it out. Now, we are here at the Marketplace, and we are joined by Andrea Warrock. She is a consumer savings specialist, and she is here to explain how we can snag those best deals in town or online this Black Friday. So nice to have you with us. Now, tell us, for all those consumers out there, what are the key things we all need to know this Black Friday?
Well, first of all, the doorbusters that you're used to seeing in-store only will be available online. So if you don't feel comfortable going out on Black Friday into the store, or you just don't want to deal with the hassle, you can shop online. You can select a drive-up or curbside pickup and still get it the same day and benefit from the big savings. But also, just know that if you miss out on Black Friday, I've seen deals ahead of the sales, and I'm sure the deals are going to keep popping up after Black Friday. So don't feel pressure to spend all your budget at once.
What are some of those deals? You know, what can we find in order to find free shipping or an extra percentage off? What can you suggest?
Yes. Well, when you're shopping online, and right now with so many sales happening, it's hard to keep track of who has the best deal and at what time. So I like using a few browser tools that really help you comparison shop. So first is PopKart. This is a tool you download to your browser, and whatever you're looking at online, it will provide a pop-up notification letting you know if that in fact is the best deal or if you can find it at another site for less at that time. So it's very helpful. And then also Honey is another tool that gives you historical pricing data. So I was looking at something online at Target. It let me know that the price actually recently increased, so I knew I better wait to buy it when it goes back on sale. So it's just something to be aware of. Prices are gonna go up and down. You just have to pay attention.
Right now, you know, technology is such a prevalent part of our lives. How can we use that to our advantage, you know, this Black Friday to score all those deals?
Well, if you're not using technology, you're really leaving money on the table. There are so many great apps and even browser tools and websites that can help you comparison shop, help you find the deals and circulars based on your location, coupons, cash back. So it's really important for you to download a few savings apps and use those to your advantage to help you find the best deals on Black Friday and beyond.
Now, if someone's, you know, ready to head out this Black Friday and they are going to go in stores to shop, what are some of the best tips they need to know in order to make sure they're maximizing on their deals, but they're also staying safe? You know, we're in the midst of a pandemic.
Right. So first of all, before you go shopping, do a little research to figure out who has the best deals on the items you want to buy. You can use an app like Flip, which aggregates store circulars all on your phone. So you can create your shopping game plan based on that, and then just order from your mobile device and pick it up curbside. So you don't have to go into the store or even try to fight for a parking spot because the parking lots will be crowded. If you can, shop at your small business retailers over the big box chains. The small businesses have been affected the most. They're the ones who were forced to close versus the big box chains that were able to stay open. So give your money to our local community. I would recommend that. They will have plenty of sales to help you out, but remember that it's going to help you out in the end as well when you shop local.
Now, we heard some of your best tips, but what, just to, you know, condense it all, what are the key points that consumers can take away this year?
Okay, so Black Friday typically causes people to buy way more than they need. So if you want to save money and you really want to manage your budget, make sure you have that shopping list. Make sure you're tracking and researching deals to save money on the items you want to buy. And don't let the deals influence your purchases. And just remember, you do not need to go into debt for the holiday season. You can make it special without overspending. Your loved ones don't want you to put purchases on your credit card that you can't afford. So just remember that there are other things you can do. You could do virtual wine tasting with your friends or family who live different areas. You could bake cookies for a friend. So just think about different things you could do without spending money.
I think that's something that, you know, we've all really valued this year, is just being with our family and spending time with them. You know, it's really at the end of the day not about the gifts. It's about just being with one another. And I think that's something so important to remember. Now, if you do plan on heading out to a store this Black Friday, make sure you're following CDC guidelines by wearing a mask, maintaining social distancing, and washing your hands at all times possible. Now, some stores are actually changing how they typically do Black Friday. Walmart this year is doing it in three separate events instead of all in one day. That is to help make sure less people are inside of the store at one time. Now, also make sure you check online for hours. Some stores will be adjusting those hours for this busy Black Friday. But that's it for us here at This Pop Kern. We'll catch you next Friday.